Try to shift the X over. So I shift this over. What do I get?
Beta. When I shift the 2X over, what do I get? Beta? When I shift the 2X over, what do I get? Is it a plus 2x or minus 2x? Minus 2x. Because this is plus, the bring over become minus. So I will have
3y. So can you write down 3y equal 6 minus 2x?
3y equals 6 minus 2x.
Now,
does it look like the red equation here, Sandy?
Yeah.
Does it look like the red equation here?
No.
Why no? No is correct. Why is it no? Look at the y here. How many y do I have?
One.
How many do I
have?
Three.
How do I remove the 3?
Divide by 3.
So I divide by
3. Y equals to 6 minus 2x divided by 3.
But I look at this, is it easy to see the MX bar C? Because here is something minus something over 3. So not that simple. So what we can do is I can separate this into something like that.
See, I just show you quickly. Then we can move on to can I write? Yeah, I can write. Okay. So this is equals to 6 over 3 minus 2x over 3.
Okay, what I'm doing is I can take this 3 and I can split. I can split into 6 over 3 and minus 2x over 3. Do you know why? Okay, let me ask you a question.
Let's try. Now, what happens when I have 8 over 10 minus 2 over 10? Can I combine them together?
Let's combine to one fraction, what do I get? 8 minus 2 over 10. 6 over 10.
So I can have something like that. 8 minus 2 over 10.
Okay, so can you see when I have something minus something over 10, I can split that into two fractions. See, this is one fraction, I can split that into two fractions. So this is one fraction, can I split this into two fractions? Okay. You understand? Now, from here, what is 6 over 2? 6 over 3. What is 6 divided by 3? 2.
So you have y. You have y equals to 2 minus 2 over 3. Then I got an x here.
Now, does this look like y equals to mx plus c? What is the number beside x? Minus 2 over 3. Do you understand? So this D is your mx. This one is your c. Do you follow?
Or you mean minus m?
So m is equals to what? Negative 2 over 3. Because this number is the number beside the x.
This minus 2 over 3 is the number beside the x. So this is your M. Then what's your C? Must be the one with no X. This is your C. So this thing here is
C. C equals to 2.
Do you understand? Take this example down first. Usually the question will not ask you like that. I just want to expose you something further. Okay, so take this question down first. A bit confusing, huh? Yeah. Usually the question will not come like that. Usually the question will give you like that. don't have 2 here, 3 here, 5 here, don't have. It's just like that. So from here, then you just draw the graph. It's simpler. This one, it is the exam syllabus, but usually I flip through the 10 series to 10. You have to take it. Take down
already. What did this year have? Okay, then we make sure we practice with a few more questions from the practice paper. Okay, can you tell me this is on page what?
Exercise 6.2. Page 8. Okay. Can all of you turn to page 8? All of you turn to page 8? Okay, we will study until 9 o'clock. No, we will study until 9:05. Then give you 5 minutes break. Okay? So 9:05, then we stop, then we have a break. Now, okay, let's start. Now, When I first look at this, do I know my gradient? Let's practice the y equals to x plus c. What is my n? 1 over 3. So can you
write down, practice, m equals to 1 over 3. What about c?
C is 2.
Okay, c is 2. Very good. Okay, maybe you want to... Okay, I copy at the side.
Okay, yours is copied here, right? It's fine. So, right now, we read the question together. We write each equation in the form AX plus BY equals to C. So what do they want? They want you to rewrite this so that there is no fraction. So there's no fraction.
So this thing here means there is no fraction.
Now, let's see how to change this so that I have no fraction. First thing, I have 1 over 3x. Do you know the x goes where? Up or down?
Up.
Top.
So, I start by writing y equal x over 3 plus 2 over 1.
Now, how do I simplify this? Is it too small?
No.
Okay, let me zoom it bigger. Okay, bigger already, yeah? So, I have something like that. Now,
I want to make it no fraction, means I need to cross on the line. But before I do that, I got two fractions. What can I do? Can I combine them together?
No.
What must I do to this? Times
3
times 3. So let's do it together.
I times 3 times 3. So here there's a times 3. Here there's a times 3. And I have y over 1 equals to x plus 6 over 3 over 3.
Can I now combine them together?
Yes.
Yes, yeah, combine them together. So I combine together, I will have y over 1.
Why am I walking up and down? X plus 6 over 3. I use my arrow. Okay, so now I have this right hand side and this left hand side. Can I do my cross multiply now? Yes, no? Yes, so I can do my cross multiply. So this one I multiply upwards. So I will have 1 bracket x plus 6. These I multiply upwards. I will have 3y.
So
far, so
good? Yes. Okay. So I want to have ax plus by equals c. What do I do here? I have a bracket. Do I distribute the 1? Okay, I distribute. So I scroll up.
So I will have 3y equal x plus 6.
Now look at the question again. The question wants the x and the y to be on the left hand side. the number on the right hand side. So what do you do to this x? Bring over. So I bring over become what? Plus or minus? Minus. So I have 3y
minus x equals 6. Hashtag. So this is the answer.
3 on the presentation. Okay, let's try on B. Then later on, you try yourself. Okay, let's try B together. What's the first step for B? Okay, we want to practice on the gradient and the C.
Beside this question, can you tell me M equals what? C equals what? Minus?
1 over 5.
1 over 5, very good. It's the number beside the x. What about the c? 1, very good.
So I got m, I got c. Okay, now let's try the question out. I want to rearrange so that I have something like that. There's no fraction. What do I do first? Where does the x belong to? Top or bottom?
So I can write y over 1 equal minus x over 5 plus 1 over 1.
Okay, so I put everything into fraction, and what's the next thing I do? Shape. What's the next thing I do? I have two fractions here. What am I going to do?
Combine.
How to combine? This is 5, this is 1, how to combine? I want to do something to this 1, 1. How much I do? Times 5 times 5.
Is
that okay? 5. So times 5 times 5. So I write down. So here I want to times 5. Here I want to times 5. So I have y over 1.
I skip one step, because if I know this denominator is the same, I can combine them into one fraction. Can you continue from here? What's the next step? Cross multiply. Cross multiply. So you want to try a cross multiply? Let's continue. Let's continue. Try the cross multiply means what? The 1 will multiply to the top. The 5 will multiply to the y. Right? Okay, I draw arrow for you, and then you do the cross multiply.
Okay, let me draw the arrow for you. This, I multiply upwards. This, I multiply upwards. What do I have on the left hand side?
Y.
5y.
Not Wi-Fi.
So I have something like that. Can you complete the question? Is it easy? Very easy, right? Well, you already have the answer. 5y minus x equals 5. Is it correct? Minus x or plus x? Okay, why I put 1 in bracket? Because the 1 here must multiply with the top. And when I multiply, it's always a bracket. So that I can distribute. This is a 1, so it's fine. It's still the same. But if this is 2, then this 2 number will change.
Can you finish off? Finish the steps. So this is minus x plus 5. But can I stop here? Swandi? I must bring the x over. What do I get?
Y minus.
Still minus?
I bring over the minus x. Is it still minus?
Plus x.
Plus x.
So you get 5y plus x equal 5. So far so clear?
Good, good. Okay, now your turn. Can you try the 2c?
Try your 1C, 1D.
Try your page 6, page 7, page 8. Let me check whether is it doable. Okay, you do page 6 first. Then after that, you do page 7 together. One question, then you continue. I bring my pen, who needs help?
Together. Now, before we start, what is my M? Minus 2 over 3. Check. Haris. My C is negative 1. Now, let's start writing the thing together. Y over 1 minus 2x over 3 minus 1 over 1.
Hey, many of you, the X disappeared. The X disappeared, so it's not correct. So the X must still be there. Now, how do I continue here? This denominator is 3. This denominator is 1. What must I do? Times 3. Times 3. Can you continue? You try. You understand now? So first step, write down the gradient, write down the y-intercept. As practice, the question is not asked. But what I want later is how to combine the two terms together, then you cross multiply. Did you try now?
Okay.
Hey, what's going on? What's going on? You want me to try your answer? Still correct. Okay, I write down the next step and then you continue the following step. Trivia, you have this? Then how do you continue? Cross multiply. So cross multiply means, well, come back. Come back to your seat. 3 must multiply upwards. 1 must multiply upwards.
So you have 3y equals to 1. Times negative 2x minus 3.
Two correct. Yeah. Now next, open bracket. So 1 times 2x. Can we try your D now?
Check your answer on C, then go on to try D.
Okay, almost done. I look at the top equation, you don't want the x, I want the x and y to be together. So what do I do to the minus 2x? 3y plus 2x give you?
Negative 3. So there's the answer already. Do you understand?
This is the answer already, no more, just like that. Okay? Is it okay? Some of you are not serious. Very good. Move on to your D. Move on to your D. Try. Try your D now. What is your N? What is your C? Write down beside E. I don't tell you the answer first. What's your N? What's your C?
If I come over, you are doing a D now. M equals to something, C equals to something. Bitten? Check the answer. Negative 1/4 and negative 3.
Alright? You get correct?
Okay. Joel, you want to show us how to do? Times 4. So I continue to write. Y over 1 minus x minus 12 over 4. Then I do the cross multiply.
4y
equal 1 bracket minus x minus 12. So 4y distribute. Minus x, distribute. Minus 12.
How to continue? How many of you get the final answer?
Correct. Is this the final answer? No. What must you do? Move. Move which one? Minus x. Move over become? Shane, I lost you already. You okay? Do you get this answer? So I walk over to your side. You are done, huh? Can you turn wrong, huh? Then you want to change? Okay, turn over to the next page. Turn over to the next page. Let's do seven. First one together, then you can continue the next one. Okay, let's start. Okay, underline the keyword they want us to find. You want to find what? Radian. Okay, so underline the keyword they want. Number one, they want gradient. They also want y intercept. Okay, now what is the form you want to rearrange into what? Y equal mx plus c. Understand? You need to rearrange. Can you write down? Rearrange y equals mx plus c. And this must be 1. So 1y. 1y. That's all. Now, I have x plus y equals n equals. You copy down the rearrange right on top of the book. Turn to the page. Something to rearrange. Okay, let's copy the first question. X plus y equal. Easy? Very easy, huh? I also find it very easy. X plus y equals minus 4. Who is on the left hand side? X or y? Really? Look at this. Who is on the left hand side? Left. Y, right? That means the y must stay. Who do you want to throw over? Javier, Shane, Ryan, or Noel? What must you throw over? X or Y? Throw X. You want to throw the X over. You want to bring it over. So when you bring it over, what do you get? Minus X. So can you write down? Y equals minus 4 minus X. So far, understand? Is this okay? Do you think it's okay? So, can you tell us, now I have something like that. What is my n? See, n is the number beside the x. So, which one is the number beside the x? Minus 1. There's a 1 here, Harish. There's a 1 here. So, what is my gradient? Minus 1. So, there's no number here, means this is a 1. Therefore, my gradient equal negative 1. So far okay? Then what is my c? If this is minus 1 is my gradient, then what about my c? C is the 1 got x or no x? No x. Which number got no x? Minus 4. So what is my c? Minus 4. C is your y-intercept, huh? C is your y-intercept. So this is minus 4. So this is your y-intercept. So far so good?
Okay, now Johnson. Try B. Now. You're supposed to fill in the blank below. You don't even have to spell the word. They spell for you already.
Huh? Do you see that? This is minus 1. This is minus 4.
So you want to fill in the word. X or Y? Do you want to fill in the word first?
Haris, what must I bring over? Haris, what must I bring over? Minus 2x. Okay, bring the minus 2x over. What do I get? Plus. So I write y equals minus 3 plus 2x.
So what's my gradient? 2. What's my y-intercept?
2.
Minus 3. So write down 2 minus 3. Okay, next one.
Try now. It should be faster. Can be faster already. Can fly already. See, so you finish D already, right? Very good. So C is done.
Okay, let's do C quickly. C is easy. I walk around, I see many of you guys see. Adrian, your C is done? Adrian? C is done? No. Why? 10 more minutes, then we rest. Okay, I want to bring what over? The 3x. When I bring over, it becomes what?
Minus.
So I have y equals 2 minus 3x. What is my gradient?
3.
Wrong. Minus 3. Do you follow? The number and the sign must follow. So this is negative 3. What about my y-intercept? 2. So this is 2. Now last one. X plus 2y, what must I do? Okay. How must I do? X plus 2y equal 2. How must I do? Skip. Okay, which one do I bring over?
X.
Bring X over. Sorry. Adrian. I bring over, so what do I get? 2y equals 2 minus x. Now, can I say my gradient is negative 1? Cannot. Hey, well, can I say my gradient is negative 1? Yes. Answer is no. Why? Because of the 2 here. I must change the 2 to 1. So I must divide or times 2. Divide by 2. So I divide by 2. So this one I must bring over. So I will have y equals 2 over 2 x over 2. Now I show you the divide as in divide individual. So I divide individual, I divide individual. It's easier to see. Change. I don't think you're teaching me, man. Really? You're teaching me, man. Please don't sample your friend, huh? Now, once I have this, I simplify this number. Press the calculator. 2 over 2 give you what? 1.
So
y equals 1 minus x over 2.
Hey, what's my gradient? What's my gradient? Gradient. X cannot. You see, I don't want x to be inside the gradient. So I circle 2. Is it 2? The 2 is at the bottom. Half. It's half. Do you have a minus?
So this is actually your gradient. Do you understand?
So 1 minus over 2 is your gradient. So your gradient is negative half.
Negative half. What is your y-intercept? This is your y-intercept. So your y-intercept is 1.
of the last one. Ta-da. So far okay? Understand? Anna? Good.
I didn't know my voice is so sweet and it's sweet.
Okay, come on, ladies. Come on, ladies. Oh, hi. Actually, 7 more minutes. Okay, let's try this. What does 1 mean? X equal to 1 or Y equals to 1? X equals to 1.
It's not very good. He's not looking at the screen, but he still know what I asked.
He can still nod and shake his head. Okay, X equals to 1. What do I want to put here? The working I put below, right?
Sir.
The answer I put here. What answer do they want? X or Y?
Y.
So what do I do? I put a 1 into
bracket.
2 bracket Y.
Bracket X.
Into the X. So I start.
So this is 1 plus 2Y equals 3.
Hey, correct. How do I find Y? What must I do? Bring the... Do it, help us. How do I solve for Y? What must I do to the 1? Bring over. Bring over become what? Plus or minus? Minus. So I have 2Y equals to...
No space. 2y equals to 3 minus 1.
So can I find y? Y equals to what? Press the operator. 3 minus 1 give you? 2. 2 divided by 2 give you? So y equals 1.
So this is? You write 1. This is y equals 1.
Do you understand? Do you need to put the y equals? No need, huh? I repeat. No need to put the y equals.
Ryan, what did I say?
I said no need to put the y equals, I no need. Because I know this is y. Can you try the second and the third one? Try now. Really? Oh! Yeah, I completed the wrong equation. Can you spot the mistake?
Minus
2y. I put a plus 2y. This should be a minus 2y, right? This should be a minus 2y.
Okay, my mistake. Good job. This is a minus 2y. So I bring over the 1 over, so this is minus 2y equals to? So this is minus 2y equals to 2. What is y?
Can I zoom in?
Can you see better?
So there's a minus, there's a minus. So the 1 bring over, this is 2. Minus 2y equals to 2. What is y? Minus 1. This is minus 1.
So what must you put here? It should be a negative 1. Can you tell me what is this box here? What number is it? And what number is it?
She will tell us the second one. Brian will tell us the third one. The rest of you try now. Then check your answer with Shane and Brian. Shane might already tell us the answer for the second one. Well done already? Done already, second one? Try it? Wait. Now I go around and mark. Who done? Minus It's not minus 2, right? Hey, any of you write correctly, but the last step, something wrong, eh?
2 minus what?
2 minus what happened? 2 minus 2 minus 2y equals to 3. I bring the 2 over. Minus 2y equals to 3 minus 2. Minus 2y equals 1. It helps to bring the minus 2 over.
Go down.
Go down. Plus or minus, times or divide. This one I bring over become? Divide. Why divide? Because it is 2, but why? 2 times. This is a multiply. Do you understand? This is a multiply. When I bring over becomes divide. Do you understand? So y equals to what? 1 over 2. That's a minus. Do you understand? Okay? So what's the answer for the second one?
Minus
half. This is minus half.
Is that okay? So this is minus half.
Is this okay? Then you try the last one. The working is here. In my suggestion, don't do here. Very poor thing. Here, the space quite little. Can we move up? And then we do the working on top.
Like no space, eh? So you do the working on top. I start for you. 3 minus 2y equals 3.
3 minus 2y equals 3. What is y? What do I do? Move the 3. Brian, what's the answer when you move the 3 over? 0. Very good. That is correct.
Minus 2y equals 3 minus 3. Minus 2y equals 0.
That's correct. But what is y? 0. Because I want to bring the negative 2 over. I divide, right? When I divide, what do I get?
0. So y equals 0. So this is 0.
Okay? Now I have it ready. Okay, so we continue tomorrow. Those of you who want to continue, what's the next step? This is a coordinate. This is a coordinate. This is a coordinate. Then you can draw on the graph paper and then you plot. Okay? Those who need to rest, put the book into the box. Maybe we'll bring it back later.
You guys, I think you never do it.